Hey everyone, Tim Schofield here from QBKing77.com, here to do a video showing you how you can flash the factory images to bring your Moto X 2014 Pure Edition back to stock. This image file is going to be found on Motorola's website, so it will be the official software. So your bootloader is also going to need to be unlocked, which I would assume you would have done, which is why you want to flash this software. If your bootloader is not unlocked, I will show you the quick command in just a second on how to unlock it. Anyways, what we're going to need to do is actually download a file. So click on the link in the description of the video. What that file is going to do is actually be the system image, but you're going to need to sign in on Motorola's website. So sign in on Motorola's website and let's go to the computer. Okay, so the website's going to look like this after you log in, so make sure you do log in and scroll down. You need to agree to this legal agreement. Make sure you do read it. And now you need to find the Moto X second generation Pure Edition image. Right now it only has the KitKat image. I'm assuming the Lollipop one's going to come soon. If you're on Lollipop, you should be able to flash this KitKat image just fine. I'm actually on Lollipop now on my Moto X and I'm about to flash this KitKat image and I know it will work okay. So just hit request download and it's going to bring you to a Google Doc page. Put in your email address, all that good stuff, and then in about 15 minutes, someone's gonna email you with that file. So you might have to be a little bit patient and wait for that file. I'm just recommending doing it this way just so you know it's the official image and it's going to work for your device. I also want to make a note that you're going to need to install ADB and Fastboot on your computer. I will link to a tutorial video that I have in the description if you need to do that. So make sure you do that now and download that file as well. Now, once you have that file downloaded, go to navigate to where it was downloaded, and also once you have the SDK tools Fastboot set up on your computer, we're good to go. So, the file is going to look like this, TMO, a bunch of numbers. It might be updated in the future, but make sure you find that file you downloaded, double click on it. I'm going to use an app called 7-Zip to open it if for whatever reason your PC doesn't open it. So, and then double click on this next one. And inside you'll see a couple folders. Now, out of the two folders, I want you to click and drag that TMO folder to your desktop. So click and drag that one onto your desktop. Now, once that's on your desktop, what I want you to do is go ahead and go inside that folder. So double click on it. You'll see a bunch of files. You'll see some folders as well. What I want you to do is select all of the files that aren't in a folder. And hit right click and hit cut or copy, either one. Cut or copy them. I'm gonna cut them because I don't need them anymore. And then navigate to where you have that Android SDK Windows folder, and then navigate to the Platform Tools folder and paste all of those files we just copied into that folder. All right, and once these files have copied over, let's go back to our phone because we need to put it into Fastboot mode. All right, and once we're at our phone, what I want you to do is go ahead and just power it on down. So shut it down because we need to get into Fastboot mode. Now, to get it in Fastboot mode, once it fully powers off, press and hold volume down and power at the same time, and then after a couple seconds, let go of the power button, and it should take us into Fastboot. So I'll show you. Volume down and power, hold it down for a couple seconds, let go of the power button, and it will take us into Fastboot mode. So you'll see it'll look like this, Fastboot flash mode. And now all you need to do is grab your micro USB cable and plug your phone into your computer now. So plug it on in while it's in Fastboot. Again, like I said earlier, your device needs to be unlocked. If it's not, I will show you how you can do that right now in the command prompt. So let's go, let's actually now go back to our computer. Okay, and once we're back at our computer, you will see all those files we pasted in the Platform Tools folder. So what I need you to do now is hold shift on your keyboard, right click, and hit open command window here. And it's gonna open up this command prompt. So it'll look just like this. Now with this command prompt open, if your device is not, actually first command I want you to type is Fastboot space devices. That'll let you know that your computer does recognize your device. If it doesn't, I will link to where you can download the drivers in the description. So you'll see, it'll show a bunch of letters and numbers letting us know that our computer does recognize our phone. Now, if your bootloader is locked, you need to type Fastboot space OEM space unlock. So type that in and it's going to unlock your device. Again, following this method is going to wipe all of your data on your phone, so make sure you back everything up. Keep that in mind. Now, if your bootloader is already unlocked or once you have it unlocked, we need to type in a bunch of commands now to flash this image. Once again, this is going to wipe all your data, so keep that in mind. All right, so the first command I need you to type in is Fastboot space flash space partition space gpt.bin. And press enter. Now it'll flash just like that. You'll see it'll show what you're doing on the phone as well, but Here, let me get you a closer look at that. So you'll see it's showing what command you're posting. I will post all of these commands in the description of the video, so you don't really need to worry about that if you forget one or miss one. Anyways, let's continue on. Next command, fastboot space flash space motoboot space motoboot.img and press enter. So it's going to flash that one. Next, fastboot space reboot hyphen bootloader. Just like that, press enter. It's going to reboot our phone back into that bootloader, that same screen. There we go. Now once it, wait for it to turn back on, and once it turns back on, type in fastboot space flash space logo dot bin. Press enter. It's going to flash that. Next, fastboot flash boot boot dot img. Okay. And then you're going to need to type in fastboot space flash recovery.img. Press enter. It's going to flash a recovery. Now fastboot flash system.img. This one will probably take the longest out of all of them. So wait for this one. This one will take a bit of time. Again, your phone is showing you progress. All right, so that one is done. It took over a minute, so just be patient with that one. Now, after that, we need to type fastboot erase modem ST1. All in one word, modem ST1, and press enter. So that's done. Now, fastboot erase modem ST2. ST2. Enter. All right, done with that. Now, fastboot flash FSG space FSG dot MBN. Enter. Fastboot space flash modem space and in all caps NON hyphen HLOS dot BIN. Enter. It's going to go ahead and send that modem over. Shouldn't take too long. All right, done. Fastboot erase user data. Enter. Erasing user data. Everything. Now fastboot erase cache. Enter. So that's it. That's all the commands you need to type in. Now just type fastboot reboot for the final command, I guess. So press enter and it's going to reboot our phone. So enter, phone's rebooted, and that would be it. So again, warning, bootloader locked. If you want to relock your bootloader, I guess I should have said this, instead of typing fastboot reboot, you can just type fastboot space OEM space lock. So in case you want to actually relock your bootloader as well, fastboot space OEM space lock in the command prompt while you're in fastboot mode. You can get to it if you accidentally rebooted it like I did right there. So that's it. I'm going to let this boot up and then show you guys that I am back on KitKat now. All right, phone booted back up. You don't need it plugged in anymore if you don't want to. And we are back on KitKat. I was on Lollipop. Now I'm back on KitKat. But you'll see all the user data was wiped, as I said, and we're done. Back to the home screen. Here we go. Working completely. That's how you flash a factory image on your Moto X. Hopefully this video helped. If it did, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to me as well. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Google+. All links will be in the description of the video below. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up.